The weather, it's finally getting warmer, and you know, you want your yard or your garden to look beautiful, obviously, but it's really important to think about your pets too. So joining us right now to talk about the dangers of gardening is Dr. Tony Kramer from Kramer Veterinary Services. Good morning.
Good
Thanks
morning.
For coming in today.
You bet.
The last time you were here, it was pets in costume,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, we did a little Halloween thing and with some dogs that were for adoption. It was really great.
Aww.
And but today, the official planting season is almost here, and if it doesn't snow again in Chicago,
I know.
Probably in the next couple weeks, people are going to be heading out and starting some gardening.
Yeah, fingers crossed that does not happen. So I have a dog, Waffles, who I love so much. We love getting outside. There he is right there, little Pomeranian.
We want to keep that little guy safe here, and so I've got a bunch of things here that are hazards as we start to head out to the garden, start to do some planting and gardening and growing some vegetables or whatnot.
Yeah.
And the first thing I always want to mention is fertilizers, because the fertilizers obviously have some toxins in them and that, but some of them actually, like bone meal and blood meal, actually are made from ground up bones, which, hey, dogs
love
are into.
Yeah.
It's going to taste good to
so
them, right?
They're going to be drawn to those.
So we want to make sure that some of these things we picked here are a little bit safer than others. Some of them say that they're safe for pets or whatnot, but we got to be careful because any of these things have high levels of nitrogen in them for help plants, but are not good for pets. Roses, the actual fertilizers they put on roses specifically have organophosphates, which are terribly, terribly toxic. We got to really be careful when fertilizing them.
So and it's not just the thorns you need to watch out for, it's actually the fertilizer.
Yeah,
that
actual plant's not too big of a deal, but the things people put on them are a problem.
Mm-hmm.
And then also we have things out here that we're trying to keep pests and things that eat our plants away. And so these are snail baits, slug baits, stuff to keep kill and repel moles and gophers. These are all things, obviously we're trying to kill pests.
Mm-hmm.
These are things that could actually really, really hurt small pests.
So what do you do? Is there safe fertilizer?
Well, to be honest with you,
these
guys here are probably as safe as you're going to get. But the bottom line is you have to realize if you have pets that there's going to be some things like that that you're either going to have to forego or somehow keep your pet away from.
Okay. Or maybe would it help to wipe their paws off too?
Absolutely. If they're going to be on grass that's been fertilized or you think they've had contact with them, sure. Any type of wiping them off. But dogs and cats both explore things with their mouth. They don't have hands, and so before you know it, they're into something, and it can be bad quick. Over here, we kind of talk about other things that have to go along with gardening, and that composting. A lot of people like to do composting, and the bottom line is that we're talking about rotting food and bacteria. The molds grow in there, something that can be really, really bad for pests to get into. And again, it's food, so they're going to be attracted to that.
Yeah, and my dog is always trying to pick up food that he sees on the street. I'm like, no,
get away from
away.
That.
Yeah. And then you also have mulch. This is really interesting.
Yeah, the cocoa mulch is something that is more and more common. It's actually made from grinding up the cocoa shells. It smells like chocolate. I think that's why people like it.
Yeah.
But it is definitely going to
smell like
chocolate to dogs. And chocolate's bad for dogs. It's got theobromine. It has caffeine in there. Both things that can be toxic, cause seizures, and even death in pets. So this is something
especially raw chocolate.
And this is, you know, there's a lot of that out there if you're doing your whole landscaping with that. So definitely that's something to avoid if you have pets.
Yeah, and then there's some plants that we need to watch out for just quickly.
You know, hundreds of plants that we can't go all over. Look at ASPCA, poison control. There's a lot of things, but big ones, tomato plants, potatoes. The actual green part of the plant is toxic to our pets, not the fruit the food so bad. And then lilies, I can't leave our kitty cats out. Lilies are toxic to kitty cats, very toxic. And a lot of people have those around during the holidays when we want to make sure that we keep our kitty cats safe as well.
Thank you so much, Dr. Kramer. Lots of good tips in here. Kramer Veterinary Services has 11 hospitals in Chicago and Ohio. So visit animalcareinfo.com or drtony.com. See this man right here for more information.